Harvey for the Mets. Dan Heron and Dylan G Saturday. Taylor Jordan and Carlos Torres on Sunday. So the Mets getting a break in some of those matchups. 2-1 to Satin, swung on and missed as Wood keeps it out away. Another changeup. And the count, two balls and two strikes.
It's cold.
Washington Nationals right now, a team that a lot of people thought, including yours truly, would win close to 100 games this year. Well, they're 5 under 500. They've lost 6 in a row, 9 out of 10. They're 9 games out of first place behind the front-running Braves, third of the division. 2-2 pitch. Sent takes a slider down and in full count.
I have all kinds of hitting issues there. Got one guy that's not really, that's Jason Worth. Bryce Harper is back in the lineup today. They sat him out yesterday. Still got a little bit of a knee situation to deal with.
Goes back to that collision with the right field fence at Dodger Stadium. Here's the payoff pitch. Sat hits it hard up the middle. Base hit going into left center field. Hustling into the gap to cut it off is Gattis. And that'll hold Sat to a single. Although Josh takes a wide turn at first but decides to hold on. And the Mets have their second hit. Leadoff single for Sat. That'll bring up Justin Turner. Turner didn't miss winning the game on Monday night by much. As he shot one towards the gap in left center, Jason Hayward, two on, made a diving catch which won the game. Two runs might well have scored if that ball had ticked off of Hayward's glove, because the left fielder, Reed Johnson, who was going in to back him up, would have clearly overrun any carrot off the glove. Quick throw to first in the dirt, and Satin's back standing. But for Turner, it's his first start since June 15th against the Cubs here at Citi Field. And the intercostal really started to bother him. It is the fourth game that he started at shortstop. Right hand batter, first pitch on the way, take it on the outside corner, a changeup, strike one call. Turner, the 15th batter of the game. Geico wants you to know that a 15-minute phone call can save you 15% or more on your car insurance. Call 1-800-947-AUTO or visit geico.com. Here's the 0-1 to Turner. Fastball outside, ball one. Turner is just 8 for his last 51. And of course, that's not all that significant at this moment when you consider he's just off the disabled list, but he was cold when he went on. Just had that one pinch hitting appearance Monday. Here's the 1-1. Fastball. It's low. Two balls and one strike. One thing about Turner, he can give you a deep at bat. He will work pitchers well. We've seen that often, whether it's coming off the bench or as a starting player where he's going to get about 4 plate appearances a game. Sat in a short lead at first, 2-1 pitch. Turner fouls the fastball back to the screen. That evens the count, 2-2. The Pirates are out now. At the top of the first, the Nationals coming up. It'll be interesting to hear the buzz when we get in there tomorrow. And whether Davey Johnson is in any danger of actually losing his job in the season. He's already said this is his last year in the dugout. He's supposed to move upstairs into an advisory role next year. Now the 2-2 pitch. Making ball in the dirt, full count. And it's a delicate situation because, you know, Davey has, I guess what you'd call, borderline managerial Hall of Fame credentials. Mm-hmm. So, you know, he's a guy who's very well thought of in that region in particular because of all his years with the Baltimore Orioles. You know, Davey and general managers don't often mix very well. 3-2 to Turner. Let's see if Sapp is running. A throw over. He did not break early and gets back to the bag easily. And there have been some uneasy exchanges previously between Davey Johnson and Mike Rizzo. Rizzo's decision to fire the hitting coach David Eckstein earlier in the week. Davey couldn't have liked that. So again, 3-2 the count to Turner. Satin leads from first. Wood staring at him. Satin runs. The pitch looped in the air towards short base hit left field. Satin will have to stop at second as Gattis gets to the ball quickly. And Justin Turner shoots one into left field. Back-to-back singles to start the home second. And the Mets have runners at first and second. Nobody out. John Buck coming up.
And just to complete your point, Howie, I think we are possibly going to see some really interesting theater this week. weekend, especially if the Nationals lose again today, because that would make it 7 straight losses at home. And you got a fan base that's starting to boil a little bit right now. This team, as you said, was supposed to win 100 games. They're not coming close. And you got a couple of pretty strong personalities there, to put it mildly, the manager and the general manager.
Here is John Buck batting at 222 with 14 homers, 49 runs batted in. Outfield around towards Riley, infield a double play down the first pitch. Fastball swung on and missed, nothing at one. To this point in the year, you have to say that both wild card spots look likely. Again, we've got roughly 60-odd games remaining for every team, but the National League Central is the deepest division. So right now, you better win the National League East, or you probably go right home. The 0-1, fastball outside, 1-1. Just puts that much more pressure on the Nationals to turn this thing around quickly. And there won't be any cushion for them. Josh Sant, the runner at second. Justin Turner, the runner at first. Not a whole lot of speed there. Nobody out. 1-1 pitch. On the outside corner, a called strike. Good looking curveball. 1-2 to Buck, with the Braves leading 1-0 here in the bottom of the second inning.
And yeah, to your point, Howie, the National League East, I think a lot of people figured somebody would lead by 8 or 9 right now, but that somebody was going to be Washington. And a team like Atlanta would be trying to get the pedal to the floor.
1-2 pitch, fastball high, 2-2. And then, of course, there are the Phillies, who have now lost 4 in a row. They're 3 games under the 500 mark. And what do? They move Michael Young. Do they try to move Jonathan Papelbon's contract? Do they make any other moves designed to set them up better for the future? 2-2 to Buck. Woods hits. Half pitch. Swing and a miss and a fastball. He struck it out. John Buck down on strikes. That's a big first out for Wood, especially with Buck unable to at least get set in the third where he can score on an out. So one away, and Juan Lagares coming up. Wood now with 3 strikeouts on the afternoon. Lagares went 0-2 in last night's game. He didn't start, but he came in as part of the double switch when Jeremy Hefner left the game in the fifth inning. Lagares is batting at 261. You go back to the 5th of June, he's hit 315. Getting the start against the lefty here. And the first pitch from Wood, a fastball taken for a call strike, nothing at one. Terry Collins has tried to find the most favorable matchups for Lagares when there are right-handed pitchers involved. Certainly wanted to keep him away from Hudson last night, but was forced to use him. He's hit 278 against the lefties. The 0-1 swung at and missed, though. That's where they pitched him quite a bit. Down and away, he waved at the changeup.
Wow.
And the count 0-2.
One thing that's got to change for Lagares, of course, is still a young player, but the walks to strikeouts ratio is nowhere close to where it needs to be. It is 4 walks against 43 strikeouts right now.
Batting here with a ton of real estate in the left center field gap. 1-0 Braves, first and second, one out of the second. The 0-2 pitch, change up in the dirt, 1-2 strikes.
He's been scorching extra base hits, though. Lagares had the home run that had to be reviewed the other day. He's also got 13 doubles already, Howie. That's 1 out of every 8 at-bats, basically. David Wright, who's obviously an all-star player, is 1 out of 9.
And, I mean, there is an enormous amount of space in left center field for Lagares right now against the lefty. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball, grounded foul over by the third base dugout. Another curve for Wood.
That's an open invitation to another double right there if he can pierce that area between left.